Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Phoenix, Arizona. And in this video, I'm giving you an update on the hearing loss restoration drug FX322 and the announcement of a new hearing loss restoration drug called FX345 and how they could be the future cures of hearing loss. Coming up. Figuring out a way to restore the function of a cochlea, which is our hearing organ, could be the biggest discovery in human history. According to the World Health Organization, by 2050, approximately 700 million individuals worldwide will have a disabling form of hearing loss. This means that discovering a cure for hearing loss would not only have a positive impact on the quality of life for individuals with hearing loss, but it would create a ripple effect that would have societal benefits around the world. A few years back, I published several videos talking about the first potential cure for hearing loss called FX322 that was designed to regenerate hair cells inside of the cochlea, and I will link those videos down in the description. Since the vast majority of hearing losses are sensorineural in nature and caused by damaged inner and outer hair cells inside of the cochlea, it stands to reason that if you could regenerate these dead hair cells, that you could restore normal cochlear function. In general, there are three different approaches to hair cell regeneration. You have gene therapy, you have stem cell therapy, and you have molecular therapy. FX322 is a form of molecular therapy, which means that they use different molecules to activate progenitor cells inside of the human cochlea in order to regenerate new hair cells. FX322 has already shown meaningful improvements in speech perception in three different clinical trials, despite disappointing results from a phase 2 multi-dose clinical trial that showed no improvement over placebo. Frequency Therapeutics is still undergoing additional clinical trials for their FX322 drug to see if single dose administration of this drug would result in meaningful improvement in hearing. They are actively enrolling for a new clinical trial, and I will talk about that more at the end of this video. However, FX322 is not the only hearing restoration drug in Frequency Therapeutics' pipeline. They have a new drug called FX345 that is intended to target more of these hair cells inside of the cochlea. But before I explain exactly how FX345 is different from FX322, if you could do me a huge favor and click the like button, it really helps out my channel because it gets these videos in front of a broader audience. And while you're at it, if you have not yet hit that subscribe button with notification bell, go ahead and do that as well because that ensures that you never miss one of my newly released videos, and I release multiple videos every single week. That being said, I really appreciate it. Now let's go ahead and talk about what FX322 and what FX345 are intended to do. Humans are born with approximately 15,000 hair cells inside of each of our cochlea. About 80% of these hair cells are called outer hair cells, which makes sounds more audible by increasing the vibration of the basilar membrane. The remaining 20% of these hair cells are called inner hair cells that actually receive this vibration and transmit neural impulses up to the brain so you can hear. Over time, these hair cells can become damaged due to things like increasing in age, noise exposure, chemical exposure, head trauma, and even viral attacks, ultimately giving you what is called a sensorineural hearing loss, which is the most common form of hearing loss. The bad news is these hair cells do not regenerate on their own, so once the damage is done, it's done. If most of the damage is done to the outer hair cells, then properly fit and programmed hearing aids can be used to successfully treat this type of hearing loss by improving audibility. If most of the damage is done to the inner hair cells, then properly fit and programmed hearing aids provide much less benefit, because even if you make the sounds more audible, the inner hair cells cannot transfer that audibility cleanly up to the brain. So it is this inability for the human ear to regenerate these damaged hair cells that is the problem that Frequency Therapeutics is trying to solve with their FX322 and FX345 drugs. So how do these drugs actually work? Both FX322 and FX345 are injected through the eardrum into the middle ear space where it forms into a gel on the round window membrane of the cochlea. Then, the tiny molecules inside of these two different drug formulations pass through the round window membrane into the cochlea. These molecules are designed to stimulate the progenitor cells inside of the cochlea to regrow these hair cells. It is important to note that these progenitor cells already exist inside of your cochlea. The whole intent of these molecules is to stimulate these dormant progenitor cells so they can do what they are naturally designed to do, which is create hair cells. So if they're both administered in the exact same way, what makes FX345 different from FX322? FX322 is limited to the very high frequency hair cells inside of the cochlea. FX345 is designed to reach much deeper into the cochlea so it has the ability to potentially stimulate the progenitor cells at much lower frequency ranges as well. Here is a side-by-side for the areas of activation inside of the cochlea for FX322 on the left-hand side and FX345 on the right-hand side. As you can see, the molecules inside of FX322 are limited to the highest frequency ranges inside of the cochlea. While this could still have a positive impact on hearing, it does not get these potentially regenerative molecules deep enough into the cochlea to have an impact on lower frequencies that are incredibly important for better hearing. FX345, on the other hand, was formulated to get more of these regenerative molecules much deeper into the cochlea, which, if effective, could make FX345 much more effective than FX322 when it comes to hair cell regeneration. As exciting as all of that sounds, we really do have to wait for the clinical trial data to come out so we can see if these drugs are actually effective in restoring hair cell function and ultimately improving hearing. Of course, I am crossing my fingers because if there is a way to improve inner hair cell function inside of the cochlea like we saw with the phase 1 clinical trials for FX322, then it could make hearing aids much more effective in treating hearing loss. If we saw successful regeneration of outer hair cells, then it might eliminate the need for hearing aids altogether. If you ask me, it is just a matter of time before researchers discover a molecular compound that can do just that. The question becomes, is FX322 or FX345 going to be the cure for hearing loss that we've been waiting for, or are we going to have to continue to wait? The answer to that question is going to be revealed in the clinical trials that are done on these two drugs. So when are these clinical trials actually going to occur? Well, if you go to clinicaltrials.gov, you will see that Frequency Therapeutics is actively enrolling participants in a phase 2 FX322 study for individuals with sensorineural hearing loss, noise-induced hearing loss, and sudden hearing loss. And there are clinical trial sites across the United States that you can contact directly if you want to be a participant in one of their studies. Now again, make sure that you are subscribed to my channel with notifications turned on, because as soon as Frequency Therapeutics announces their FX345 clinical trial, I'm going to be making an announcement on my channel. This way you can get a head start in enrolling in that clinical trial when it becomes available, probably sometime in 2022. At the end of the day, it is impossible to know if and when any of these drugs will actually cure hearing loss, and the best thing that you can actually do is treat your hearing loss right now with whatever treatment option is currently available. This way, whenever the drug does come about that can cure hearing loss, your brain has been receiving auditory information from now until then. Because we still do not know how long-term auditory deprivation from untreated hearing loss could potentially negatively impact your brain's ability to receive benefit if and when we are able to regrow these hair cells. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you like the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, feel free to check out my website, drcliffaud.com.